you are kindly requested to turn off all electronic devices, including cell phones. The kingdom of God is like a mustard seed, which springs up and becomes the largest of plants, like a tender shoot from the cedar, which will bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. So shall the just one flourish like a cedar. As we walk by faith and not by sight, may our lives bear fruit in abundance. This liturgy is being offered in honor of living and deceased fathers. We begin our prayer by standing and joining in singing number 606, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 606.
Thank you. strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without your mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one in God forever and ever.
Amen.
The readings can be found at number 1123. Number 1123.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel, I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees in the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words from the antiphon to the psalm are, Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
Walk by faith, not by sight. yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please Him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
That when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them, as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them. But to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
My dear friends, on this 11th Sunday in the ordinary time, it is also the day which the Lord has given us to celebrate the gift of our fathers in our lives and all those that have played the father figure in our lives. Each one of us has got personal experiences of who these fathers have been in our lives. We thank him for this gift, and we continue to pray for them. It is not an easy thing to be a model to others, especially as we grow up, looking at them in our world. It is in our circle that we encounter God's love through them. So we pray for them, that God may give them graces to continue to be those models to us, to be God himself in our lives. We pray as we had the intention also for those that have passed on, that the good Lord may give them the reward of being in our lives as fathers. Today, the words we have heard from the scriptures are words, one would say, of consolation, words of assurance. Words of assurance as we continue the journey in life. He has given us examples from the first reading we have had, Ezekiel, talking to the people about the sprout of a seed of cedar he is going to plant from an old one. Why? It's because at the time he spoke those words, the people of Israel were in captivity. They were in Babylon. And when they were there, life was not easy. The captors had tremendous powers over them. They subjugated them. They made them do whatever they wanted. So they had no say. And I think you can recall one of the sayings when they are saying, how can we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land by the rivers of Babylon? The Lord says, even if it looks that there is no hope, your captors have mighty powers. God's powers are stronger than that. God in his own time is going to raise up a cedar, a branch that will grow, and that is your hope. Don't give up hope. He will be there. In the second reading, we have had Paul talking to the Corinthians, who had believed, had come to believe that their world, their life was not on this planet, but with God, Jesus, with Jesus who had conquered death and who had rose from the dead. And yet, that second coming was not coming. They were not being assumed to heaven. They were wondering how to live in this corrupt world. And Paul says to them, don't lose hope. The Lord will come. The Lord is with you. We walk not by sight, we walk by faith. That is what he told them. Don't lose hope. Keep courage. And the gospel, we have had those beautiful parables about the seed, about how the farmer puts the seed in the ground, germinates, grows. And the miracle of the growth from a seed, from a tiny thing to something big. That is how the kingdom of God is. And so he is saying the same thing to us, to understand that this something which cannot be recognized, which is the kingdom of God in our midst, which sometimes we don't perceive, we don't experience, which sometimes we doubt whether it is still there. When we see calamities also in our lives, when we see floods, people dying, many people have died in the country where I work, in Nairobi, in Kenya rather. During the rainy season, we lost over 270 people. They are wiped away by the waters. When you see all these people cry, where is God? When we see on the news about the tornadoes that are in the western part of the country, people losing all they have worked for, losing their lives, we ask, where is God? We ask, where is God in our own personal lives? For each one of us has a story to tell, and part of these stories may have something that has hurt us so bad that we want. We still cannot reconcile ourselves with that. We ask God, where were you? God, where are you? Some of us are still going through the same now. Maybe we have so many difficult situations brought about by so many conditions, healthy conditions. We visit the doctor and doesn't tell us about the news. Financial conditions. We may have relational problems, challenges of how to relate to our people, in our small families, to our people, in our vicinity, to our loved ones. Maybe there are those we have had the misunderstanding and have not forgiven and are not forgiven. And we ask God, where are you? He is telling us, he is telling you, I am there despite all this. I see your suffering. But the kingdom works miraculously, silently, like that seed that grows, and the farmer doesn't know how to grow, but it grows into a big tree. Like the mustard seed, the tiniest of seeds, which is insignificant, and grows into something big, into which all the birds, he speaks of all the birds of the air to come under its shade, meaning it is God with all his love, mercy, and concern, that everyone who comes to him will have, will share in the shade. Let us pray for ourselves, my dear friends, that God may give us the graces we need to have hope, and not to give up, and not to lose hope, even when the going looks like it is tough, even when it seems God is not there, is there. I want to remind you of that story we have had, the steps, I think that's what they call them, the steps on the shoreline, that whenever you see that somebody says, God, you promised to walk with me, but when I look back where I have walked, I can see where we have got two sets of feet. But sometimes, especially when it was very hard for me, I only see one set of footprints. Where were you, God? And God says, my son, my daughter. When those moments were with you, when they were so hard, it is when I lifted you. When I carried you, the Lord carries us. The Lord is always with us. May he continue to be with us, to see us through thick and thin. And let us not lose hope. May he fill us with graces. We now profess our faith in our God. I believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of all heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified. I believe in one holy Catholic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead.
The Lord knows our every need and urges us to pray to him with confidence. We therefore join in now with all God's people in coming before his throne and offering these our petitions and prayers.
That as the Church continues to foster the growth of the kingdom of God on earth, her members may grow in unity and holiness, we pray to the Lord. That efforts to promote and preserve peace between the nations may be marked by perseverance and reliance on God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
that God, who places value in the smallest of his creatures, may renew in our hearts an act of love and reverence for all children, born and unborn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are fathers, that on this Father's Day they may be affirmed and strengthened in their calling. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may bless Father Elias in his vocation and his return to Africa, and for Father James, and all priests that are starting their new positions, that God may continue to bless them in their ministries and bless their parishes with a smooth transition. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our parishes and all families, that our merciful Father may continue to bless us, keep us, and help us to grow together in love and faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are ill may be comforted and healed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, all the deceased fathers of our parish and are recently deceased, that they may have eternal rest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all the intentions we hold close to our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Father, we rejoice to be your sons and daughters. As you seek the fulfillment of our needs, we long for the growth of your kingdom in our lives, in our families, wherever we are. Bring us safely to our eternal home. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we offer our gifts to the Father, we join in singing number 861, Praise and Thanksgiving, number 861.
Thank you.
acceptable to God the Lord in the merciful Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord the Holy Father, Almighty God and eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us, the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored the gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we are praying. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." By the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Anthony, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Pope Francis, our Pope and our Bishop Alfred, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family gathered here before you this morning, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, especially our deceased fathers and whose parishes we remember today, in your compassion, O merciful, grant them eternal rest. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you have bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins and sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited at the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the blood and blood of Christ protect us in this life and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We are.
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On this day, when we celebrate our fathers, let us ask God for a special blessing on us all, and especially on them. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing. Amen. May he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
So that on this life's journey you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has come to an end. Let us join the peace and the love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you, we humbly pray. Into hell, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, pass into hell, Satan, and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls.
We thank you all for coming and wish you a blessed day and a nice week ahead.
Our parish communities would like to celebrate and recognize all our high school and college graduates. To honor them, we will be having a special graduates' blessing at All Masses next Sunday, June 23rd. A reminder that St. Anthony's Choir is selling mugs with a picture of the exterior or interior of the church for $18. There are order forms in the vestibule, and representatives from the choir will be in the vestibule after All Masses next weekend. Renewed in faith, we go forth singing number 677, A Living Faith. Number 677, we will be singing verses 1 and 4.